Hello there, everyone! We are back with some more Pokemon! Let's go! We've got some exciting things going on in the land of randomization! So if you guys are excited, I am always excited. So I went back and healed, took a break, got some pizza. It's midnight now. I can't really hide what time it is because it says it down there. So, whoops. Not that I'm ever very worried about hiding what time it is. Ooh. Is that really good? User snares the target with grass and trips it. The heavier the target is, the greater the damage. Does this get stab? But it's a grass move. You know, I'm gonna straight up get rid of tackle. I might actually get rid of grass knot as well. I could always reteach it. Because I almost think it's better not to have Electrike. Nice. That's not bad. I'm not gonna fight it because I'm probably gonna use Quick Attack to finish it off, and that's going to put me in a bad position. Look, I just said I didn't want to fight you. I think you just got a level stronger. That's fantastic. I appreciate the fact you got stronger for me, and also possibly changed genders. But I don't want you. Hey, it's Chinlin. I'll fight Chinlin. Because I apparently don't.
I don't like you, so I'm gonna not attack you.
And then you have,
I like you, so I'm going to attack you.
This, I think we're almost done the forest, which is cool. I'm excited for it. Get to move on, get some new Pokemon. Pretty excited. It's been weird. Like, a couple of the Pokemon have been, like, huge game changers or something for me. Like, Vulpix was one of them. I don't know. Vulpix isn't, like, a rare Pokemon, but just the fact that I found Vulpix was amazing. I was super happy. Are you okay? Oh, hold on. Sorry, Mittens just knocked something over. Mittens, are you okay? Sorry about that. Where I have my bottles, I put all my returnables in a box, and he just knocked over the box. Sorry about that. Okay. I don't remember, is this just, like, defense? Actually not bad. You know what? See you later, buddy. I can certainly say I was not expecting that. Let's see. Shoot, I forgot to buy a regular potion. Did I? Totally. No, I didn't forget. I just neglected to. They're like, pfft, regular potions. Alright, so we'll send out Life Fennec.
Pursuer! A kid like you beat some of us? I can't be, but I'll take you.
Okay, bring it on. I got no problem with that. I'll kick your booty 15 ways sideways. I was going on about it, but then I stopped. Altaria is one of, like, the really big surprises, and Torterra was also one of them, because it was something, you know,
far beyond what I'd ever believed.
But, yeah, no, it was cool seeing them in it. Absolutely. Slakoth heals him? Got it. Time to send out a different Pokemon. Let's send out... Let's send out Pikachu. Because we can get Fire Spin to do continuous damage, Confusion. I think I'll actually start with Confusion. I like Confuse Ray. Encore. Fine, I'll swap out. I'm not gonna use all my confusion, people. Smaug. And then, oh, he's a normal type, so fighting is super effective. So that's actually really good. He also has I gave him retaliate, so we could revenge kill with him. I don't remember if I actually said that. Wow. Just insta-kill. Talo. A stand. I'm not too worried about a Talo. Let's use Chip Away. Oh yeah, I'm defensive. As long as we're not fighting any Swampert. Weird. Another Talo! I'm gonna try out Remoraid, or our savior. He hasn't gotten a lot of good combat in, because his defenses are pretty bad. But I'm hoping that it's Talo's defenses are even worse.
No!
Oh wait, no, I'm recording. Because... I don't know why I'm using that. I guess if it has something, I can take it. This keeps up! I don't remember what he was saying. Fine, take a stupid skull! So the dream our king had, the dream we had, won't come true. Holding up, fellow subject of our king? Gorma the Seven Sages. I'm mortified that this skull, which we went through so much trouble to obtain, was stolen from us so easily. It's not important. We can afford to abandon the Dragon Skull. According to the results of our research, it's not the legendary Pokemon which Team Plasma is looking for. It's completely unrelated. We'll not allow anyone to disrupt our plans. Get away with it. We will fix it so you'll never interfere with us again.
Oh, sweet! A bug Pokemon, we're getting all worked up, so I came here. And when I spot my little iron important looking guy, are you here to help your friends whom are defeated?
I am a bird! The others didn't have anything. And who are they supposed to be? This guy, the big boss?
I am one of the Seven Sages of Team Plasma. Betelgeuse, another of the Seven Sages. What a great Pokemon. And return to the Seven Sages, okay?
You guys are a little against us now. To you, the bug Pokemon user Burr and the normal Pokemon user Luna, I say, know your enemy, know yourself, and no need to fear the results of 100 battles. I mean, the unexpected, and don't underestimate your enemy. Just saying. This time we shall retreat quietly to secure the liberation of Pokemon and steal Pokemon from Pokemon trainees, even though your gym leaders will not tolerate any further obstruction from you. In that case, we'll settle this someday. I hope you're looking forward to the time as much as I am. They're a speedy bunch. What do you plan to do, Burr? Are you gonna chase them? We gotta back this Soul Skull, we cornered them. No telling what they might do. I think I'll head back. Well, now. Nah. Well. I'm waiting for you to challenge it, Castellina Pino's City Pokemon Gym. And yes, I'm certainly looking forward to it. So he's bug. Look, he's gonna be whatever Pokemon, we don't know. I mean, you're holding the Dragon Skull. You worked so hard to get back, right? you so much. With a kind trainer like you, taking care of the Pokemon must be very happy. Have this. It's a Moonstone. It's a Moonstone. It evolves Pokemon. I must use the Dragon Skull. Peace out, brah. Who evolves with a Moonstone? Like, new Pokemon, not old Pokemon. I know old Pokemon that evolve with Moonstone. Oh, I don't have Musharna. Or, I don't have Lunarize on my team anymore. Miracle Seed just powers up grass moves. That's absolutely something we're gonna give to... Oh, I don't know if I actually showed it on camera. I went and talked to the person, about what Pokemon I started with, and that wasn't about Stone. Stones is later in the game. That was Charcoal I got. Well, I picked Charcoal because I wanted to give it so it would power up my fire moves. I believe it's a 20% power up, I think. Hi, Mittens. How are you? Oh, pretty kitty. Yeah. You're a good kitty. Yes, you are. By the way, say hi to Mittens every time he pops in a video. I'd love to see just a bunch of comments like, "Hi, Mittens." He's adorable. Tree is cut. Florida sent to Driftvale City. What's up? He was just sleeping underneath my desk earlier. All right! I always thought this was super cool. Oh, Quick Claw. That's actually pretty decent. For that, I'll actually use Quick Claw for Smaug, because Smaug is so slow. Obsessed with certain items like buying for one. Got it. This is the cool bridge thing. Well, the bridge curves right here. I've never seen anything like it. You've never seen a curved bridge? You know, in a Pokemon game, I've never seen it either. Well, up to this point. I really love, like, just how far they went with, like, X and Y. They make huge leaps and bounds going to Sun and Moon. The game looks a lot better. I'm searching for the exact center of the bridge. So question of the day, what was your favorite, like, innovation or new thing that they brought to Pokemon? Mine is abso-freaking-lutely when they added in costumes in X and Y. And then also in Sun and Moon, there's also costumes, but... anything where you can, like, customize your character. It's so weird, because games like Skyrim, I don't give a crap about customizing the character, but the fact that they put it in Pokemon... when I first played any of those games, the number one thing I cared about was exclusively looking at the different outfits. So these people. And, that was, yeah, it blew me away because I loved...
You okay?
I loved how it, like, made it more unique. Unrecovered Pokemon? Oh, sorry. You know Geonat? No. See the globe on the second floor? That's Geonat. Register. Okay. There must be some kind of online feature, which I can't do, so I don't care. What do you want? Pokemon trades help connect with the world is bigger. Oh, okay, that's cool. Oh, wait, sorry. Oops. No. Take a rest. People and Pokemon. My favorite way to spend lunch break is watching ships at the dock. Grumble, grumble, grumble. I should change my Pokemon moves. Grumble, grumble, grumble. Oh man, I'm gonna be like completely lost here. Studio. Hey there, Blondie. Yeah, I'm gonna be like 100% lost here. I don't remember this town at all. Landscape control. Pokemon! Whatevs. What about you? Hey, trainer, show me your... Oh, okay, we're just gonna fight. That's perfectly fine.
Show me your moves!
Oh, it's a Swablu! Oh, that's a little funny one.
Swablu!
Excuse me. It's probably actually going to have a Dragon-type move, which is going to be really bad for me.
Sing has such bad accuracy.
Why does it always hit? Oh, man. Alright, I'll just tough it out.
Oh, astonishing. Oh, astonishing.
Thank you. No! I just want to break through to attack. Alright, I'm gonna switch out Pokemon. It appears that it doesn't have any dragon-type moves. I mean, granted, trainers aren't, you know, smart. A lot of the time. Or at least a lot of the time they don't act smart. No, screw it, I'm just gonna use Dragon Rage. 40 guaranteed damage. There's no way in Sheeta's that it's gonna do more than 40 damage.
My movement lacks power.
Oh, here's a question. I don't actually know. I'm not sure. If this is true or not. But, did this game have, like, worse leveling than the, like, originals? Was it, like, I'm trying to think, because in the original games, it was if you kill a level 2 Rattata, you get 24 experience, for argument's sake. I don't remember what it was. I think it's, like, 16, 18 or something. So, no matter if it was a level 1 Pokemon or a level 100 Pokemon, you always got 24. Because I used to do that when I was a kid. I'd be like, alright, so 24, that means at a minimum I need to kill X, and then it'll go from there. In this one, it's based off the level difference, isn't it? I think. Please correct me if I am wrong. I know it's, like, beneficial in a lot of ways because you're getting extra experience. If you fight someone stronger. It's fun. You want to go up? Sure, you don't have anything suspicious. Okay, you can go. I don't know what this place is. I probably shouldn't have gone up. Which floor would you like to go to? 47th floor, I guess? What is this place? Okay. Welcome to my party. Enjoy. I would actually not be happy if anyone was invited to my... Well... Alright. Okay, see you later. I'm done. I don't know what this place is. Yeah, so I don't know. if this game actually had like the scaling experience or not, or if it has just been in Pokemon and like maybe they rebalanced experience gain or something. I don't know. But that's just, you know, a little food for thought. Hey, what's up, blue-haired girl? Pokemon trainers on Route 4 show combinations of Pokemon during the construction. Alright, awesome. Awesome. We'll check out Route 4 then. Maybe I should try to catch a Pokemon on Route 4. Sure. Definitely. Hey, it's all dirt. I just love seeing Oshawott out here because it's so sandy. That's hilarious. Oh my word. I don't want Oshawott. I like Duwot. Duwot's one of the Pokemon who I really like their middle stage. I'm trying to take a look at the sand. You know the ears are lighter and darker. Some Pokemon hide in sand. Sure. Let's see a couple Pokemon in the sand. Now, Gothitelle is like the equivalent of Gardevoir, I think. I think it's like Gen 4. It's supposed to be like Gen 4's equivalent of it. Not a big fan of it in comparison. What's up, boy? Well, okay, rest here. Sweet! I'm glad I checked here instead of running back to go to the Pokemon Center. I might actually need to do some, the Gulag! I might actually need to do some leveling, since I'm struggling to, keep up with trainers. I mean, granted, I have Pokemon who are, like, fully evolved and stuff. And that, like, Altaria, it's like 36 or something, so... At that point, you'd probably just be getting enough experience. I don't know if that actually, like, pseudo-scales or what. How it works. But we'll see a couple of Pokemon. Oh, shoot, that's a fossil Pokemon, isn't it? I think I'm gonna try and catch it. I think it is a fossil. But I can't remember. Because, I mean, it never hurts to have, like, the more unique Pokemon. It's got Aqua Jet. That's pretty good. But I do really want to keep our Lord and Savior. He's way stronger move-wise than Altaria is. My god. I don't know. So, I am going to be very flexible about my team. Dratini's never, ever going to leave my team. And Vulpix is never going to leave my team. I know who I am. Vulpix is not going to leave. This doesn't really matter if I get knocked out. Might as well just keep trying to do small amounts of damage. Actually, arguably, that's way stupider to try and do small amounts of damage because it doesn't benefit me. Let's send out Sakura, I guess. Balls at it. Great ball specifically. Maybe a net ball wouldn't be bad because that's good for water and like Pokemon. I think that's what I have. Damn. That's a physical move. Oh, I guess it actually wasn't that bad. Yeah, net ball. Let's just throw. I almost wish you could actually pick, like, what Pokeball Pokemon go in. because it would be really cool to, like, almost transfer. I'm gonna do that, so... I should switch out to Dratini and use Wrath. Mitten's just crawled inside my boot. Like, he stuck his whole head in my boot. What has Rollout, too? Jesus. Rollout's a strong move. I'm pretty sure he's a ground type, which is why... Or is he rock? I'm gonna try it. It'll increase my catch rate. Okay, he is a rock type then. Oh, and Rollout's actually a rock type, so, or a rock move, so he's actually getting stabbed on that. No, Smough gets super effective against. Excuse me, he's actually causing trouble for my team. I gotta catch him. Elsewise, I'm gonna have to knock him out or I'll friggin' white out. That would be embarrassing. I mean, granted, I'm just trying to catch a Pokemon. I could have knocked him out way easier just using Grass Taunt. But we're actually trying to catch him. Yes, it is a fossil. Restored from a fossil. This Pokemon can dive to depths beyond half a mile. That's crazy. You'll be called Little Dude. I don't remember what it was actually called in Finding Nemo, but like the little guy, the little sea turtle. I just thought he was super cute. Alright, well, thank you very much for watching this episode. I do sincerely appreciate it. We'll be back in the next episode. I'll probably do some leveling off camera here. We'll see you guys then. Have a good one. Bye-bye!